Sarah Palin took a few minutes off the stump today to take an important call. A foreign leader, one of our allies, on the phone to show his support for her and John McCain, or so she thought. Unfortunately for Sarah Palin, she got punked. Bad. The Republican vice presidential nominee thought she was chatting with French President Nicolas Sarkozy. Let's put it this way, she wasn't. In fact, for nearly 7 minutes, Palin allowed herself to be engaged by two notorious Canadian radio pranksters, the comedy duo known as the Masked Avengers.
This is Bexy.
Hello, Bexy.
Hi.
Hi, this is Franck L'Ouvrier. I'm with President Sarkozy on the line for Governor Palin.
Yes, 1 second, please. Can you hold on 1 second, please?
Yeah, no problem.
All right, thanks. Hi, I'm going to hand the phone over to her.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm going to put the president on the line.
Okay, he's coming to the line.
Okay.
This is Sarah.
Governor Palin.
Hello.
Just hold on for President Sarkozy. 1 moment.
Oh, it's not him yet, Bexy. I always do that.
Yes, hello, Governor Palin.
I'll just have people hand it
yes.
Right.
Yes, hello, Mrs. Governor.
Hello, this is Sarah. How are you?
Fine, and you? This is Nicolas Sarkozy speaking. How are you?
Oh, so good. It's so good to hear you. Thank you for calling us.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Thank you, sir. We have such great respect for you, John McCain and I. We love you, and thank you for spending 2 minutes to talk to me.
I followed your campaigns closely with my special American advisor, Johnny Hallyday, you know?
Yes, good.
Excellent. Are you confident?
Very confident, and we're thankful that polls are showing that the race is tightening. And
well, I know very well that the campaign can be exhausting. How do you feel right now, my dear?
I feel so good. I feel like we're in a marathon, and at the very end of the marathon, you get your second wind, and you plow through the finish.
You see, I got elected in France because I'm real, and you seem to be someone who's real as well.
Yes, yeah. Nicolas, we so appreciate this opportunity.
You know, I see you as a president one day, you too.
Maybe in 8 years.
Well, I hope for you. You know, we have a lot in common because personally, one of my favorite activities is to hunt, too.
Oh, very good. We should go hunting together.
Exactly. We could go try hunting by helicopter like you did. I never did that. Like we see in French, on pourrait tuer des bébés phoques aussi.
Well, I think we could have a lot of fun together as we're getting work done. We can kill 2 birds with 1 stone that way.
I just love killing those animals. Take away a life. That is so fun. I'd really love to go as long as we don't bring Vice President Cheney.
No, I'll be a careful shot. Yes.
Yes. You know, we have a lot in common also because except that from my house, I can see Belgium. That's kind of less interesting than you.
Well, see, we're right next door to other countries that we all need to be working with, yes.
Some people said in the last days, and I thought that was mean, that you weren't experienced enough in foreign relations. And, you know, that's completely false. That's the thing I said to my great friend, the Prime Minister of Canada, Steph Kars.
Well, he's doing fine, too. And, yeah, when you come into a position underestimated, it gives you an opportunity to prove the pundits and the critics wrong. You work that much harder.
I was wondering, because you are so next to him, one of my good friends, also the Prime Minister of Quebec, Mr. Richard Z. Sirois, have you met him recently? Did he come to one of your rallies?
I haven't seen him at one of the rallies, but it's been great working with the Canadian officials in my role as governor. We have a great cooperative effort there as we work on all of our resource development projects. You know, I look forward to working with you and getting to meet you personally and your beautiful wife. Oh, my goodness. You've added a lot of energy to your country, even with that beautiful family of yours.
Thank you very much. You know, my wife, Carla, would love to meet you. You know, even though she was a bit jealous that I was supposed to speak to you today.
Well, give her a big hug from me.
You know, my wife is a popular singer and a former hot top model, and she's so hot in bed. She even wrote a song for you.
Oh, my goodness, I didn't know that.
Yes, in French, it's called Du Rouge à Lèvres sur une cochonne, or if you prefer in English, Joe the Plumber. It's his life, Joe the Plumber.
Maybe she understands some of the unfair criticism, but I bet you she is such a hard worker, too, and she realizes you just plow through that criticism.
I just want to be sure. I don't quite understand the phenomenon Joe the Plumber. That's not your husband, right?
That's not my husband, but he's a normal American who just works hard and doesn't want government to take his money.
Yes, yes, I understand. We have the equivalent of Joe the Plumber in France. It's called Marcel, the guy with bread under his armpit.
Right. That's what it's all about, is the middle class and government needing to work for them. You're a very good example for us here.
I seen a bit about NBC. Even Fox News wasn't an ally, about as much as usual.
Yeah, that's what we're up against.
I must say, Governor Palin, I love the documentary they made on your life. You know, Hustler's Nailin' Palin?
Oh, good. Thank you. Yes.
That was really edgy.
Well, good.
I really loved you. And I must say something also, Governor. You've been pranked by the Masked Avengers. We are two comedians from Montreal.
Oh, have we been pranked? And what radio station is this?
This is for CKOI in Montreal.
In Montreal? Tell me the radio station call letters.
CK... Hello? If one voice can change the world for Obama, one Viagra can change the world for McCain.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I have to let you go. Thank you.
Yeah! Woohoo!
Somewhat puzzling that no red flags were raised when the Sarkozy impersonator named French singer Johnny Hallyday as his special American advisor, or that he referred to Canadian singer Steph Kars as Canada's prime minister. Meantime, here's a reaction to the call, which took 4 days to set up. Palin's camp said she was, quote, mildly amused, c'est la vie, quipped the spokesperson Tracy Schmidt. David Wade, speaking for her rival Joe Biden, said, quote, sounds like the same people who didn't vet Sarah Palin didn't vet her calls.